should I be excited about the Vauxhall Grandland X? Are you in the market for a mid-size crossover? A Nissan Qashqai or one of its ilk, in other words? Yes, I am. Then no, you shouldn't be excited. No one should be excited about this car. Because it's not exciting. Nor is it intended to be. This, as far as TG is concerned, is a shame. Manual or auto? It's a question of the lesser of two evils. Straight choice would be auto, but it's a £1,500 option. The manual is weak, though. Cumbersome shift, which balks and robs the Grandland X of smooth progress. They care more about the practicality of the 514-litre boot, 1,652 litres with the seats folded, than they do the look of the dashboard. The cabin is tall, so those in the back, sitting slightly raised compared to their chums in the front, have a reasonable view and sense of space. Any gadgets worth mentioning? Apple CarPlay and Android Auto are both supported via the IntelliLink infotainment system that's standard across the range, as is dual-zone climate control, cruise control, LED running lights, parking sensors, etc. How does it drive? Unambitiously. It'll do what an undemanding driver needs it to do, and do it with reasonable competence. It's peaceful enough on the motorway, it's not going to bounce itself into a ditch on a country road, and it's easy to place around town, the benefit of the high seating position. But really, it could do better. There's suspension noise and a bit of structural shake that rivals are more successful at masking. And that's the problem for the Grandland X.